And joining John tonight, it's Aisling B. Wonderful to have Aisling B with us tonight. Usually when Channel 4 feature a young Irish woman, she's wearing a dress like a Christmas tree and marrying a scrap metal dealer. Aisling, did I have Countdown in Ireland?
Yes. I've actually never watched Countdown before. Because I'm not a nerd! No, but I think I might be brilliant at it, and I think with John, I'm on the same team. I think we're with a really good chance of winning on this
team. Doesn't sound like we're on the same team with all your nerd chat.
I'm really excited to be on John's team. I think it's going to go really well. There's no I in genius.
Aisling, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have brought a picture of my mammy. With me as a baby. My mother loves language and English, and she especially loves punctuation. She'll kind of throw it in anywhere, like she's mad for an inverted comma. So as you see here, it's myself and my mother, Irish, both wearing green. And on the back she has, Aisling and Helen, we were always proud to be Irish and loved wearing green. And she does it on my birthday card. She writes things like, happy birthday to my wonderful daughter. What do you mean, mother?
Did your mum used to be a jockey?
She did used to be a jockey,
no,
yes.
That's not a euphemism, that's like a real question.
No. Yeah, I was just a result of a ride that went too far. can I have a vowel, please?
You can indeed.
O. Another vowel, please.
E.
Yeah. And then a consonant.
G.
G.
Oh! That noise means, Aisling, you get a bonus round! Aisling, what will happen now is you have a chance to win your team 6 points.
Oh!
What will happen is you will find a bag next to your seat. In that bag are some knives. What you have to do is throw the knives at this board. Every time one of those knives stick in the board, you win your team a point. But every time a knife sticks in me, you lose a point. It's as simple as that. So can we drop the lights a little?
I might take cover.
Pop out the way, love. This shit's happening. Okay, take the knives out of the bag.
Oh, Joe, there's only plastic forks in here.
Did no one read the fucking emails?
Charming, funny, and dare I say it, easy on the eye. Aisling is very much Ireland's answer to Sean Locke. Aisling, what's your favourite Irish phrase?
I have a friend who only speaks in Irish phrases. He just goes, ah, sure listen, look it, sure listen, we'll be grand, sure Rolling Stone got us no moss. In 10 years' time, we'll all be dead or laughing at something else. And you're kind of like, yeah, but I was asking for directions to your house, Sean, so I don't really know. Ah, sure listen, look at too many cooks, you know yourself.
Now, I also noticed earlier, I noticed you're wearing a very nice jumper with a robin on your sweater.
Yeah.
This evening, but if you're the way your hair's sort of hanging over the beak, it looks like a potato. Have you got a mascot today?
Yes, I do have a mascot actually. The last time I did the show, I was a little bit nervous. I feel like I lost focus and I wasn't entirely together. And so, yeah, I've been really trying my hardest and practicing with a really supportive, motivating beatboxing friend, obviously. So, you know, just to have him around, he makes me feel better and more confident about myself. He's always testing me on things. Thanks a million, Ross. Like, say, for example, so I'll try one now and just give it a go. So looking for a 9-letter on this. Possibly show busy?
Not for show busy yet.
Great, good, going well. So like let's try another one now. Oh god. And again I want to go for 9 on this, Susie. Beatboxer!
Beatbox! Oxford.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah, great. Another thing now, what's it? Oh, I'm not great with the numbers now. John, do you remember, wasn't very good with the numbers at all. But let me just see. 50 plus 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 50 plus
Aisling, what have you got?
I've got banisters.
Let me just check and see if banisters is up there.
Yes, it's in there.
Oh. Aisling, did you get it?
Do you know? Oh my God, I got it! Oh my God, I have gotten it.
I've never made a woman do that before.
yeah, I've gotten it.
I don't want to be Mr. Piss on the Fun, but did you get it using that sum there?
What happened?
I didn't get it.
Aisling, what happened there? Talk us through what happened.
Oh, who knows what happened, Jimmy?
I do.
I got to 900, and what did I get to?
You got to 900 and you took 24 off, and instead of 876, you thought that was 986.
Really? I just saw what I wanted to see. Like many women with hope.
And I ruined it, like so many women with hope.
Aisling studied classical acting at the London Academy of Music and Dramatic Arts, an esteemed institution that's produced some of the country's most well-respected baristas. Aisling, are there any Irish words or phrases that we should be made aware of that English people wouldn't know?
There are lots of different phrases that are technically English, but people don't understand. Like, for example, my mother sent me a text today. Actually, David, you could translate if they don't understand. Would you do that?
Yeah, no problem.
OK, so, I mean, it's fairly simple. She's like, "Hi, Aisling! Well, didn't someone on the Rob leg it off with your man's messages after he's after coming out of Spar because she only after horsing and nagging and a pint of my waddy into her, and she was so gee-eyed off her hoop that she didn't she wallop him with one of them yokes he lobbed down the jacks. The guards found the poor crater hiding and shivering like an abused pie bowl in a hot press in her gaff, offered to give him the shift or the ride if they let her go. Ah, but you're lucky, you know yourself, she was grand-like." David, what was that again?
Just the police are investigating an incident in a shop.
OK. Aisling, have you got a mascot?
Well, I'm a big believer in paradressing, so I'm going to wear, for the show, this little number, and it's like... it's called a tracksuit. And it's got all of the trappings of a tracksuit in that it's, you know, there's a lounge-like quality to it. But then there's a sort of... a formality and sense of occasion to it of a tuxedo. And then it's got like a little dicky bow at the side. So whoa. People, yeah. So people might be like, "Where's she off to? Some sort of celebrity gala, perhaps?"
Or maybe to get married in Liverpool.
Yeah. And I've also got one for my partner in crime here, the co-captain of the fun plane, as I say. John, that's your one there.
It's all right, John, it's sort of like a cardigan.
What I've also done is, just to sort of relax us, get us in the mood, I've made us a little cocktail, just to kind of, again... It's just because I want to make it special. So I've kind of, like, made us up a little cocktail. It's very humble in many ways. It's just a couple of bits I found in the kitchen, just, like, the fresh berries, you know, bit of Mr. Muscle, some things like that. Because I often think if you can't handle a few kitchen products, if you ingest them, like, you should really be drowned in a bag anyways. So... So these are just two little genius juices. There you go, John.
To feeling great.
Aisling, what have you got?
I have got for you, Jimmy, Be better at miming, Rachel. I have...
Rachel, are you signalling to me?
I'm trying to give a seven-letter word. The only one I've seen is bondage.
Yeah, which is exactly what I got as... Yeah, bondage is what I get. That's why I took so long to say it, because I felt really restricted by the idea. That's what
I think
I
you
got.
Should definitely go with that and not bongo. Which, yeah.
What did you get? You got bongo.
No, I didn't.
Did you get bongo?
You get bongo. Is anyone O?
Exactly, Sean. Exactly. So
you didn't get bondage either, did you?
But everyone's stabbing me in the back today. Everyone I thought was a friend.
I'm afraid you're on the wrong team if you want to play hard and fast with the rules. There are reasons we're all here today, and the minute you disrespect the rules of Countdown, you piss in the faces of everyone in this country over 60.
That sounds like quite a specialist website. Sean, how many did you get?
Seven.
Well, let's hear your seven.
Bondage.
No!
Aisling?
Aisling.
How many letters did I get? In what the game we just played?
Yeah, in this game, yeah.
I got, eight.
Eight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Vic?
Five.
Sean?
Five.
Okay, what did you really get?
Auditors.
Not what did David get and pass to you? What did you get?
I got what he gave me, and it was auditors.
Oh. You crack under interrogation.
Yeah.
Quite
yeah, I got a little help from a friend. It's not cool to have someone help you out. Then I'm sorry, but I don't like this game.
Yeah, I'm eating my words.
You're eating his
words. Let's see if she follows through with this. Okay, there's going to be no edit here. We're going to watch this.
You know what? I'm so angry at you, I'm going to fucking swallow it as well. I think I'm going to have to spit out the paper because I feel a bit woozy from the pen ink.
Can you put that in a bin or
pop
something?
That's great. That is.
I can see why you didn't finish that. It's pretty gross.
Have you got an Irish accent? Have you got an Irish accent off me?
No, I don't think so.
Oh! That noise means, Aisling, you get a bonus round!